हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, थैंक यू फॉर लाइकिंग माय वीडियोस। विद द रिक्वेस्ट ऑफ वेरियस स्टूडेंट्स टू स्टार्ट सम अदर टॉपिक आल्सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम द डिजाइन ऑफ रीइंफोर्स्ड कंक्रीट, आई एम स्टार्टिंग अप विद द डिजाइन ऑफ स्टील स्ट्रक्चर्स। सो आई विल बी डूइंग इट वेरी सिस्टमैटिकली ऑन द डिजाइन ऑफ स्टील स्ट्रक्चर्स ईच एलिमेंट। ओके, नाउ बिफोर आई स्टार्ट विद द डिजाइन, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन इट इन रीइंफोर्स्ड कंक्रीट, we must understand that what are the various design philosophies on which the system is designed. Okay, so a steel structure is basically designed based on three design philosophies as given by our code. The first design philosophy is working stress method. Second design philosophy is ultimate strength design or plastic design. This plastic design was introduced in IS 800 in 1962. The third design philosophy is based on reliability based design, that is also called limit state design. Okay, so which code is applicable for the design of steel structures? We will be always following IS 800, and for concrete structures it was IS 456. Now IS 800 initially had a working stress design methodology. In 1962 there was a revision in the code and it introduced another design philosophy based on plastic design. Okay, now the latest code, that is IS 800-2007, the latest edition of the code has now introduced limit state design methodology. So what is the difference between the three? I'll be just quickly going through this video about this particular difference. Now when we are talking about working stress design method, in working stress design method the loads are not changed. On the loads we do not put any factor of safety. Whatever load we calculate, we assume that we have calculated it accurately. There is not going to be any increase in the load in future, so we do not take any factor of safety on the loads. Instead, the factor of safety is taken on stresses. So permissible stress will be taken as yield stress divided by the factor of safety. So what I am trying to say is that whole of the stress is going, whole of the factor of safety is going on the stresses. So stress in steel, because it is steel design, so stress in steel will be taken as yield stress divided by factor of safety. Okay. Now what is the value of this factor of safety? The code has mentioned different numbers for the factor of safety. If you are designing a tension member, code says take a factor of safety of 1.67. For beams also it took a factor of safety of 1.67. For long columns 1.92. You can see maximum factor of safety is on connections. That is between 2.5 to 3. See, if let us say I have a beam of steel, I have a column of steel. Obviously, I need to connect the two. How will I connect it? A very simple thing is I will overlap the things, although it is not possible to overlap every time. I'll show you with the videos and with the models that sometimes it is not, we cannot overlap the things. And then we will be putting it with the rivets or with the bolts, we will be connecting the system. Okay? So we need to design this member, I need to design the column, I need to design the connections also. Now maximum factor of safety is given on connections. Why? Because connection, if a connection fails, it will actually lead to failure of more than one member. So failure of a connection will be a more catastrophic kind of failure. So that's why the code always give maximum factor of safety on the connections. Okay, so this is basically working stress design methodology. Now what are the limitations of this methodology? First is it does not take into account local increase in stress. Okay, it says whatever is the yield stress you divided it by factor of safety, but by chance at any point there is a local increase in stress, code does not talk about that. Okay, then it does not consider the reversal of stresses, reserve of stress beyond yield. See, it takes Fy only as the stress. But we all know the stress strain curve of steel is beyond yielding. It has this kind of stress strain curve. So at this point, it will have again an increase in stress. It has more stress carrying capacity, and this is the ultimate stress of steel. But code says that we will design it only for Fy. So it means it is not taking the reserve of stresses that was available in steel. It could have handled more stress. So we are basically uneconomizing the sections. We are assuming that steel can take only a stress of this value. Okay? Then it does not put any factor of safety on the loads. It never says that the load can increase. Okay? Now, in order to fill in some drawbacks, another method was proposed, that is ultimate load design. Okay? Or load factor method or plastic design. Okay? Now, in this particular, whole of the stress was shifted to loads. It says, whatever load you have calculated, you multiply that load with the load factor. You increase the load by multiplying that working load with a load factor. So this clause, this particular design procedure said that whatever load you have calculated, that is dead load, you multiply it with 1.7. That is, you are increasing the load by nearly 0.7 times. Then if you have a combination of dead load plus live load, you increase it again by 1.7. If you have a combination of dead load plus wind load, you increase the loads by 1.7. If you have a combination of dead load plus wind load plus live load, you increase the system by 1.3. Okay, clear? So this philosophy does not consider the brittle failure. It does not consider the failure due to fatigue, and it does not assume that there can be a manufacturing defect in steel and we need to put certain factor of safety on steel also. Okay? So that is why this particular method was said to be not working, and we have now shifted to limit state design methodology. Now, limit state design methodology increases the loads also. It decreases the strength of the system also. So it means it is putting the factor of safety both on load and on strength. Whatever load they calculate, they say increase it by certain amount. Whatever is the strength of steel, they say that decrease it by certain amount to assume that there can be some manufacturing defects in steel. Okay? So it deals with various limit states. What do we mean by limit state? It means it is the state at which there can be the failure of a structure. Okay? So beyond which the structure ceases to perform its intended function satisfactorily. So the code divides this limit state into two categories. One is limit state of safety, ultimate limit state. Second is serviceability limit state. That means ultimate limit state are the ones that have to be followed, otherwise the structure will collapse. And serviceability limit states, they are desirable. If not followed, they can cause discomfort in the system. So what will be the ultimate limit states? They will be related to strength, they will be related to stability against overturning, they will be related to failure due to buckling, fracture due to fatigue, brittle fracture and all. Because of these, if let us say there is an overturning of structure, it is total collapse. If there is a buckling of the column, it will lead to collapse. So that's why they must be followed. Whereas in serviceability limit states, we say that the deflections have to be within the limits. Okay? The vibrations of the structure should be within the limits. Cracking due to fatigue should be within the limits. Corrosion will be within the limits. So these are desirable, but these are must to be followed. Okay. So I'll just quickly tell you what are the basic things that you must understand in these limit states. First is, I have already told you that partial safety factors are applied for material as well as for load. What do I mean by this? Partial safety factor for material. The code says that the ultimate strength, design strength, will be taken as ultimate strength divided by gamma m, that is partial safety factor. Okay, where it is given, it is given here over at this particular point, partial safety factors for loads, partial safety factors for materials. Okay, that is partial safety factor for material, gamma m. Okay, where this is gamma m is the partial safety factor for material. It is introduced to account for possibility of unfavorable deviation of material strength, possibility of unfavorable variation in member sizes, possibility of unfavorable reduction in member strength due to fabrication and tolerances, and uncertainty in calculation of strength of the members. So whatever are the uncertainties in materials, the code says that you need to give in this partial safety factor. And the code says that this value of gamma m will be taken as 1.1 for members, for tension members, compression members, beams, etc. And this factor will be taken as 1.25 for connections. So it means again in this code also more factor of safety is given for connections, because connections will lead to more drastic failure. Okay. But if you remember, in working stress design methodology, this factor was very high, 2.5 to 3. So we have reduced this factor from 2.5 to 3, from this to 1.25. Okay? So this is how the factor of safety has been introduced in this. Now, again some partial safety factor for loads is applied. That is, the loads are enhanced, loads are increased by multiplying it with factor of safety. Where is it given? All the things are given in on page 29, page 29, clause 5.4. Okay, it is given in this particular clause, and this partial safety factor for loads, it is specifically given in table 4. Okay, it says that if you are having a combination of dead load plus live load, that is the most important combination, then you will increase the dead load by 1.5, you will increase the live load also by 1.5 if you are taking the limit state of collapse. If you are basically talking about limit state of serviceability, you will increase this particular, for dead load you will increase it by factor 1 and for live load also by factor 1. That is, you are practically not increasing the loads. For serviceability you are not increasing the loads, but for collapse limit states you will be increasing the loads by 50%. Okay? If you are taking a combination of dead load plus live load plus wind load, in this case you will be increasing the loads by 20%, that is 1.2. Okay, clear? But most of the time we take this particular combination, so we will be increasing the loads by 50%. For collapse limit state, but for serviceability limit state, we will be not increasing the loads. Okay, clear? So this is a major difference between this particular limit state. Clear? So next class, in my next video, I'll be starting up with the design of tension members, taking the background of these things. Okay, thank you.